Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play House of War. Well, not Let's Play. God dang, I'm messing all my words up today. We're going to be doing a multiplayer video because it was going to be a Gun Squad video. But my save data for that and the backup version of it are corrupt. So I need to replay through the first island again. So when I get through that, we'll be doing another video of that. But for now, multiplayer. I don't have anyone here because I'm lonely as crap. Either way though. We'll be doing a multiplayer video, and I've kind of decided that first video was we did Survival Novice. So the second video we'll do Expert, third video will be Strategy, and then we'll keep going between these three until the final two episodes of the multiplayer. We'll do a custom map generated and a custom code, because random and code are about the same thing, and I probably won't do Deathmatch, because I noticed Deathmatch goes on for a long time. I've already done all the settings, we'll be doing double health. No sudden death, because that just kind of seems a bit annoying to me. I've never really had a match go for that long, but... oh well. 30 second timer, plus one pigs. So we'll be doing Survival Expert, and we're gonna do Square Off. And that's not my team. Where's my team? There's my team. I'm not going to mess with the ranks this time. I'm just gonna give what I have. And... let's rename one of them. Actually, no. Well, let's do this. Because I never showed this off in the single player, I don't think. But with this little code here, if you name your team Murdy Pigs, if you name them that, the team is now purple. That does not mean we get any special bonus or anything here in the... if you do this code in the single player and or multiplayer, it only means you play as the second purple team. And I'm saying that for a reason, because Team Lard, as you see the team name there, is different than Murdy Pigs. Because Murdy Pigs is just your original team, like if you played as the British and you beat the game and you're going through on Murdy Pigs now, it's just a British team, but the color has been swapped to purple. Team Lard, however, the difference is that every pig, or at least most cases, each pig will have a different accent. So we can have five different nations of pigs here, all on one team. And in multiplayer, they have their own little special quotes and stuff from the announcer, not from the pigs themselves. They still have their regular pigs, but they'll all be a different nation. So we'll do that, and let's just spam this whole lot and see what team we go up against. Feng Shui. I just read the first name instead of the team. Chinese, I pressed the wrong button. Alright, let's start game now that I'm done messing up everything. So yeah, was going to be a Gun Squad video, but the data is corrupt, so I need to replay it through it. And hopefully it won't happen again, because it's a pretty frustrating thing that happens with console versions of the game, I've gotten those. Emulator and PC, I believe, are fine, but the original console just does not seem to work right. And the paratrooper has infinite catapult, infinite machine gun, infinite bazooka, and 3 jetpacks. And let's go ahead and grab this grid here. What's in here? Cluster grenade. Ooh. That's gonna help. Ooh. I kind of don't want to be here because I know this guy has some heavy artillery because it's a gunner. But you can never tell how the AI is going to act in multiplayer. Because it can either be Marty Pig difficulty or it can be level 1. Ooh, mystery crates. Always forget about those things. They're only in the multiplayer. That's one thing to keep in mind. If in single player and you see a box with question marks on it in single player, it's a spy, period. They don't exist in single player. In multiplayer, however, these quids do exist. Oh boy. Alright, who else is here with me? Scout, okay. And I see there's a scout over here. Rocket launcher. Nice. I don't actually have to try. I'm gonna try and keep hidden behind walls and stuff because, well, it'll help you survive a little bit if you don't get shot every turn. And because I don't have a medic, because I didn't change anything around, it might help me a little more. Wow, there's a lot of secret crates on this map. That's what I figured he'd do. There are 4 pillboxes on this map. This is one of the few multiplayer maps that actually does have vehicles. Iron turrets. I don't think any of them actually have vehicles. But when we make our own map for one of the final episodes, I will make sure that we actually see one of the vehicles that did not appear in the campaign. Oh my god, 2 super airbursts. Why would they give this gift to me? And let alone 2 of them. Please don't, that's not short. Okay. A little far, but if you guys love the super airburst, these things are dangerous. Jeez. Oh my gosh, so close. Oh, I wonder who's stuck on the... Sometimes pigs will be on those islands. I got lucky there. Unless he gets to it. Okay. That's kind of mean. Alright, what's this one? Catapults. Ah. They're not always really great things in there. Sometimes you can actually just get pistols. No mines, if I didn't mention that in the last episode. Oh, wow. Alright, so let's go over here. Because it's going to be his turn next. And I want to hide behind this, so if he does take the pillbox, I'm good. There we go. I said on him. 50 damage, not bad. That's what I figured he'd do, so now we can take him out pretty easy because our engineer is also over there. And the engineer, if we remember, pretty good at taking out buildings with that shrapnel today. Aww, he's smartened up. Who's gonna aim at? He's gonna run out of time. Dude! Oh my god, I've never seen that happen before. Alright, let's see here. Rifle burst, that'll help, I suppose. And... Jiminy Crickets, they really want me to go out here. Normally you don't get this good a weapon away in the secret crates, but might as well take out that pillbox. And I took the pillbox to give him some cover. Jeez, I normally never get this type of stuff from this. I don't think you can get a shockwave, though. I don't think I ever showed off that weapon, either. Oh, so close. They both have 4 over there. I didn't even think to check who that was, but it makes sense of that Grenadier over there. Well, that's me. Yeah, let's just take them out, because jetpack trick, they both have 4 out. And let's grab that mystery crate as well, I suppose. Around, go here. Hop, why not? See? He has infinite catapod, but we just got more catapods. That's normally what you get from the mystery crates instead of an airframe airstrike or 2 super airbursts. But like I said, I'm fairly confident in saying that you cannot get shockwave from it. I don't think it's possible to get shockwave out of any other place than just the legends. I don't think you can get it. I just kind of feel bad for this guy. You undertake to trembly bottom lift in the yellow cam? Probably because you're occupying a talent vacuum. Alright. That was this guy's turn. Let's go over here. And I'm getting behind cover here. Because I know I can really screw this up. I'm not good with mortars. Maybe. I think that's short. Ah, fur. Oh, as long as it detonates the barrel, that's all I want. There we go. Ah, that'll do it. He's not dead, but he is injured. He'll die next turn. Wow, that thing doesn't have... This is something you rarely see. Toads versus toads. And, yeah, not very effective. You know what, Anza? Because we have this, let's just full power shoot over there and see if we can kill this guy. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You got hurt at least. Yeah, that turret's probably going down now. Almost no way it's not. Yep, there it goes. So now our Gunadir is exposed. Well, it's not going bad so far. Ouch. Oh, Saf only has 41 HP. So I hear that, buddy. Oh, come on. Oh, yeah, if you're curious what that crate is, that one right there, pretty sure it's a Super TNT, and I'm pretty sure the one over there is also a Super TNT. But no one spawned on the islands this time, so it doesn't matter. Jump! Man, there's only two of them left. Just realized that. Ah, so we need to go on the bridge and we get the glitchy animation. Because if I remember right, in the campaign at least, sometimes if a pig dies on a bridge, it would do a drowning animation instead. It will drown in midair, but I believe the boots appear back on the bridge. Alright, this guy's almost no sweat. That's my face, dude. Ouch. Alright, this should... This won't take him out, it's not enough. But this will do a lot more damage than he did to us. There we go. We can take him out for too much longer. We might lose our Grenadier mainly because... Ouch. Well, actually, now we got a jetpack on this guy. We'll do it. We got two jetpacks, okay? I'm running out of time, so let's just back up a little. And let's see how decent of a shot I can do. Why can I never do that in the campaign? Sure. And there's the purple armor cards. Alright, you're the only one left. And you're not gonna make it much longer. And I can't talk. Oh, come on, man. He took the most damage, surprisingly enough. I wanna push him in the water, just to add insult to injury here. Trigger. Not me. Yeah. Okay. Hopefully that pushes him far enough. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Victory to Team Bird. With everyone practically at full health. Jeez. Alrighty though. Sweetie was the double death doer, which was the gunner, I believe. No. No, that was our Mayo Trooper. There we go. I got 10 points. They didn't get a single point. Oh, that's funny. Well, alrighty then, though. I know it's a bit of a short video, but if I do another one on top of this, it'd be a half hour long. But either way, though, next time we come back to Hogs of War, we will be doing Gun Squad. I will make sure to have a fire already. And multiple backup saves, instead of just one. So, and when we come back tomorrow, we'll be doing potentially the finale of Dragon Ball Z Budokai. Potentially. I'm not exactly sure on that. But there's a good chance of it. So, either way, I will see y'all tomorrow. Hope you have a good day.